Hi everyone, here's an application of the equilibrium rule. On the left side we got two guys painting a house. They're standing on this scaffold here. This guy's not standing too carefully. And on the right I drew it again. Try to be a little more simple about the whole construction. What we have to consider is the weight here of this metal scaffold, and we got the two painters here, and it's held up by two pieces of rope. And if that's the case, we can ask the question, if both painters weigh the same, was the tension in the rope? Okay, fair question. Fair exam type question. So how do we tackle this? Well, use the equilibrium rule. Equilibrium rule says, If the velocities are not changing, then all the forces must be canceling out. The velocities are not changing, and forces cancel out. Okay, so then what we have to do is actually identify the forces. So we have the tension and the rope. Put the rope there. The tensions are of the ropes are pulling upward. So let's say the forces up are tension and two ropes. And then we have the scaffold. The weight of the scaffold is pulling down. So forces down equal weight of scaffold. And those painters back up here real quick. Hello. Poor guy. Okay, and two painters. Okay, and maybe a little bit later we'll put some numbers to this, but right now we just want the concept. And so the concept is the equilibrium force. Oops, sorry, one more thing. We got the weight of these guys going down. So there's three forces down, two forces up. Got it. Equilibrium rule says that the forces up has to equal the forces down in order for everything to have constant velocity. In this case, we're going to assume the velocity is zero. And everything stays zero. That's the key. It's not changing. And so the up forces are two tensions, two ropes, and tension in each rope. And then we've got the scaffold and two painters. And so if we divide everything by two, the tension in one rope is going to be half of the weight of the scaffold plus the weight of one painter. Right, so divide scaffold by two, also divide two painters by two. There you go, just do a little algebra. And that's how you do it. Cool. Okay, new question. If the painter on the right moves to the middle of the scaffold, will the tension in the ropes change? So remember we had the situation over here. They're on equal sides and they weigh the same, so the idea is that the tension in the ropes would be the same. But if we move the guy on the right, it moves to the middle, and this guy on the left didn't move at all. Hang on, little guy. Does the tension in the rope change? What do you think? Yeah, it does. Over here, if you look at this left-hand side, this rope is trying to support both painters. And on this side, this rope is kind of supporting like half the painter. So the tension on the left rope is going to increase, and the tension on the right rope is going to decrease. It's going to go down. Right? And as the painter continues to move over here, and after he stops, and everything's back at rest, back in equilibrium, we apply the equilibrium rule. And we'll see that more tension will be created on the left rope and less tension on the right. Okay. Will the increase exactly match the decrease? Okay, so starting again, what is this question saying? Well, starting over here, we said the tensions were exactly equal. If the painters are, you know, same distance away from each other, equally placed on the scaffold, and they weigh the same. And as this guy moves over and then stops, we would say that the tension over here is going to increase. And this is going to decrease the tension. And he moves a little bit more, and this is going to increase more. This is going to decrease more. And the idea is yes. For every bit of extra force, tension over here, there's going to be a corresponding decrease in force, decrease in tension on that side. And it has to in order for equilibrium rule to apply. We need all the forces to cancel out. And the weight of the scaffold, the weight of these people, they don't change, no matter what this guy does, walking around or whatever. So all the weight forces that point down have to be canceled out by the weight, sorry, by the tension force being pulled upward. How does each rope know how much to change the tension? Oh, I like this question. It does seem kind of magical. Or maybe these ropes are alive. Hey, and they talk to each other. No. No, they don't. I'm just being silly. It's just a rule in physics. It's just the equilibrium rule being applied here. It's just nature. As the person walks over here, the painter moves over here, and he chooses to walk over that way. And as he shifts his weight over, and everything doesn't collapse or break or change its velocity, then it just correspondingly happens that the tension has to increase on this side to support the greater weight being shifted to that side, that end, the left side of the scaffold. It's just naturally happening. Nothing mystical about it. All right, let's put some numbers to the whole thing. All right, and I kind of changed it up a little bit. A little creativity here. That doesn't hurt, I hope. Let's see what we got. We got the scaffold again. We got tension. And I said the tension was 500 newtons on this rope and 300 newtons on this rope. Person on the left, he weighs 400 newtons. So that downward force, the person on the right, don't know. Ooh, okay. Here's the problem. We want to know how much this guy on the right weighs. The scaffold itself weighs 100 newtons. And so, yeah, there's the question. How much does the person on the right weigh? Well, the equilibrium rule says that all forces cancel out if there's no changes in velocity. Okay, so that's going to be the assumption. We're going to say everything's at rest again. And stays at rest. In which case, the force is pointing up. That's the balance. And cancel out, the force is pointing down. I can't get it all in here. Okay, we have to just refer to it. You kind of have part of that up there. Okay, what are the forces that are pointing up? Those are the tensions. So that's 500 newtons and 300 newtons. That's a total force that's going upward. Let's see what forces are pointing down. Those are all the weights. We got the big guy on the right. I'm sorry, that's my left. The painter on the left weighs 400 newtons. The other painter, person on the right, we don't know. That's right. We're going to use the x variable for that. We don't know. It's an unknown x. And then can't forget the way of the scaffold. It has mass too. It has weight being pulled down by gravity. And we're told it's 100 newtons. Okay, and we're going to have to use some math in this class. Sorry about those of you who don't like math, but it shouldn't get too bad. Let's see, add 500 to 300. You can use a calculator. Hopefully you don't need to. 800 newtons. The 400 and the 100, add those together, get 500 newtons. X kind of stays there. Okay, and then the algebra kicks in. This is addition. So what we have to do is subtract. Sorry, I don't know why I put that line there. Looks like division, sorry. No, we're just subtracting. 800 minus 500 is 300 newtons. And then 500 minus 500 is zero, leaving us with x. And there you go. Person on the right weighs 300 newtons. He has to. If you somehow measure the tension in the ropes, and the measurements are 500 and 300, and you independently measure this guy, it'll be 400 newtons. Weigh the scaffold, that's 100 newtons. The only way for this object, all these people, to remain at rest, is for this person to weigh 300 newtons. Yep, because 400 plus 100 is 500 plus 300 is 800 newtons pointing down of force. And then the tension force pulling up is 500 plus 300. That's also 800. Yep, the forces are canceling out. Thanks for watching.